explain to a non-believer if he was to say, okay, you have the Quran, which is free from doubt, and you have the amazing, authentic hadith of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and having such two, how would you say to him that he says, well, you still live in groups, I mean, you still, you know, are in groups. I'm talking about not in groups, I mean, as in Shia group, Ahmadi group, yes. And so on.
Yeah.
So how would you explain to him, having such, you know, a book, free from doubt, how would you explain to him that we still live in Shia group, Ahmadi group, where we differ in, you know, beliefs?
I would say, what has this got to do with the religion? If I have a barrel of water, yes? If I have a barrel of water, and we agree, yes, this is a good barrel, and the water is pure water. And I take one cup of water, and inside the cup I put some poison. I mix the water with the poison. And I take another cup, and inside this one I put something else. And inside this one I put something else. Will a person say, it's an argument, this is not water because this other water is mixed? What argument is that? Doesn't mean anything. It doesn't mean anything. It's not an argument for anything. We'll say Islam is the truth. You can see the Quran. You can see what the Prophet ﷺ said. There it is. The Quran and the sayings of Prophet. Now that's between you and Allah. As for these people, Allah will ask them about what they did and about what they said. If they took something from Islam, and they changed something from Islam, and they mixed something from Islam, this is not blaming Islam. It's not the fault of Islam. This is the fault of the people. We are not asking you to follow people, we are asking you to follow Allah. We are not asking you to follow people, we are asking you to follow Allah.